This is Subjit Roy, Group Editor, Electrical India. I welcome you to Minute to Minute, an audio-video news brief dedicated to the electrical and power sector. Electrification remains an important business area for ABB, and the company is very optimistic about their growth in the Indian market. Recently, ABB Electrification has organized an international media day in Bergamo, Italy. On the sidelines of this event, we speak to Tarak Mehta, President Electrification Business of ABB. Listen to the future plans of ABB for the Indian market.
Look, we are bringing a lot of new technology to India. We see significant sectors where we can make a difference, whether it's e-mobility, whether it's building automation, whether it's also some of the new innovative solutions that we have developed from an energy efficiency and impact perspective. We have a good organization in India, led by CP Vyas, and we are confident in the growth, and we are fully investing as if the future potential of India continues to be strong.
Right. Sir, you said that you have achieved significant growth in Indian market. Can you just quantify that growth?
Yeah, I mean, as you can see, we have public records in terms of how we grow.
Right.
So we are in the quiet period, so I cannot count, cannot comment on the latest quarter.
Right.
But we've had double-digit growth in the business portfolio for electrification through the second quarter, which we're quite happy with. Given the economic environment on the industrial side of the business, where we have big exposure, the fact that our teams and our business has grown double digits is quite encouraging for us.
Right. So we are almost at the end of 2019. So
yes.
What's on card for ABB in India for 2020?
I mean, 2020, we are reshaping the portfolio, as you know, a little bit. The solar inverter business is something that we made a decision to divest.
Right.
And that would be, let's say, a substantial change in the portfolio.
Okay.
But along with that, we're bringing in new technology into India, whether it's data center specific,
right,
whether it's e-mobility,
right,
whether it's overall saving,
right,
on the building side, which is,
right,
energy efficiency is quite a big important topic in India, which is where we are also focused.
Where do you see the growth is coming from out of these domains what you talked about?
I think we see on the infrastructure side,
right,
certainly the government of India spending is resulting in some good development for our business.
Right.
Then we see some changes. We go from the traditional heavy industry to more light manufacturing.
Right.
So discrete food and beverage, the quality of life related industries,
right,
we see some good growth and good potential in those.
Right.
And then you have these focused areas where there are government programs where we clearly see the opportunity.
Right. When you talk about government policies, government is focusing on smart cities, so the renewable energy targets, 175 gigawatts. Then they have e-mobility in the card. So where exactly ABB is placed in these three areas?
I think all these three areas are important to us. Let's start first with the e-mobility. We have a lot of infrastructure development we,
right,
do in the rest of the world with other governments, and we're happy to support, and we are, you know, supporting Niti Aayog with the first installation of the fast charger,
right,
to bring a concept of the technology into the country. Then, as you move into the smart cities, it's all about what does the smart city do for the people? Is it more efficient? Are we reducing the load on the air conditioning? Are we making the buildings more efficient? So the connectivity has to result in an improvement along two or three dimensions, four dimensions. Use, meaning you get more out of the same input of energy. Second, connectivity, but it should again result in something more efficient, better.
Right.
And third, but more importantly, it should provide a positive impact to this environment, meaning it should have an impact on the sustainability, the pollution, which is a challenge everywhere in the world, but specifically in India, it's a significant challenge these days. And we can come up with solutions which will actually impact all three. And that's what we think about and we execute now.
Right. Acquisition of GE Industrial is being considered as one of the major acquisition for ABB Electrification. And it has made significant impact in U.S. market, what we could understand from the presentations made,
yes,
today. How do you see that same sort of business activities in India post-acquisition of GE Industrial?
So GE Industrial Solution also has a significant India component, actually. We haven't talked about it yet.
Right.
But in Hyderabad, we have a group of people, very competent, capable, who are former GE Industrial Solutions employees, who are actually helping us improve our entire portfolio worldwide. So we're keeping that team, we're giving them bigger opportunities and more places in the world where they can have impact, and they're part of our continuous improvement product portfolio team, which we run on a global basis. And the biggest numbers of people are GE, former GEIS employees, right, who are making a big contribution. So that's one aspect of it. The other is the portfolio. So we're here to serve the GE install base in India, which is not that small given its history. And then we're going to build on that GE install base with new digital solutions that help make it more efficient and more productive, the install base.
Okay. ABB Electrification has got an R&D center in India.
Yes.
And you said that you invest almost 3% of your turnover.
Yes.
In R&D. What kind of investment comes into R&D in India? And
typically in India, we actually have a higher percentage of turnover. So in R&D in India is done on two dimensions. Okay. One for India,
okay,
where we invest and make sure the portfolio meets the local needs. But then, as I described to you, we have Hyderabad, but we also have in the switchgear business some global product development teams,
okay,
which are based, funded, and support not only India, but also out of India. So our R&D presence in India is higher than the just 3% of the Indian revenue volume. First of all, we invest more in India as a percentage. And then on top of that, we have globally funded R&D that we do in India for the rest of the world.
So is that a kind of certification for the Make in India movement?
Of course. I mean, India is one of the more competitive markets,
right,
with very tough requirements on cost and price and performance. Mm-hmm. And the skill set of the team we have in India with that capability and a very clear understanding of software, digital services. So as you can think about many software competencies of different kind in India, combine that with the design competence and a tough market means the people we have in India are quite good at developing very compelling from a cost perspective, but also as the world moves to digital, very unique solutions in India. So we're using them to also help us with the digital side of the global scope of ABB.
So now if I have to talk about ABB Electrification's current focus in this thing, the presentations made, it was very clear that you have focus on US as well as China. Where does India stand? Again, I'm coming back to the first question.
Sure. I mean, you have to look at it from the size perspective. Relative to US and China, India is a significantly smaller market. Hmm. It does not mean it's less important to us.
Right.
Because of the investments we have, the market position and the growth potential of India, we are very focused and committed to make sure that Indian business development is in line not only with the local market, but also provides us a manufacturing base for supporting at least the Southeast Asia region.
Right.
And in some cases, we have global product portfolios which are based in India, meaning serving the rest of the world. So for us, India is a long-term attractive market where our investments, our talent is being developed more, not just only for India, but also for many applications in different parts of the world. So what you see here in Italy, we will have similar capacity and capability in Bangalore or in Hyderabad, where we're not only doing things for India, but we're doing things for the world, utilizing the skills and capabilities of the colleagues we have in India. So that's what we want to do.
Any roadmap or time frame you have?
Well, we're already doing that with a few products already. Right. So if you go to Nashik, you will see many such equipment installations and many such product the development opportunities. So on the medium voltage side, we're doing it. And on the product improvement cycle, whether it's breakers, whether it's some of our contactors, we utilize the skill set in India. So it's, we don't have to talk about the future, we're doing it now. And the goal now is, as we move our business more towards digital, more towards solutions that we talked about, think about solutions in food and beverage, think about solutions in e-mobility, then the solution business requires digital capability, okay, which we believe India has, and that's where we will use.
So are you getting the right kind of ecosystem for the same? Because it's not only ABB which can deliver the excellence. Do you have the ecosystem in place?
I think there are some pockets where you see an electromechanical competence in certain parts of India. And you see some software competence in different parts of India. The application competence is an area where we still need to really get more capable and more experienced professionals. But what I mean by that is there are, in the world, there are 30 verticals that we serve. And not every vertical has an equal weight in the Indian economy and the Indian situation. So in those verticals where India is not having significant volumes, nor the ecosystem, We just need to make sure that we develop the competence in the people through having them go experience it from outside of India, whether it's through an assignment or spending time with the customers. Because at the end, we want to develop products that and solutions that meet more than the needs of India. For sure, the market is important, but the real leverage is when we can take that product and sell it, like we do today.
Right.
But we just like it to be not few, we like it to be many.
You are also in the board of ABB in India. So what kind of commitment, revenue commitment, do you have to the group from Indian subsidiary?
I mean, our commitment is to continue to grow the business as we have. So Sanjeev and the team, their responsibility is, look, make India a significant part of ABB, and they're doing a good job in terms of delivering good value. And you can see that in the share price appreciation over the last few years. So it's not only us, but also our independent shareholders recognize and value the contributions. So they have a free rein in terms of investing in the business, but we want to see the continuous growth of profits as well as revenue. That's the only small requirement we have. Double digits better than single digits. Okay.
Shifting to a different apart from ABB, the power sector in India is going through different challenges.
Yes.
So what kind of, what's your take on the sector, if you can just let us know?
I mean, I would say there are two components to this. There's the generation and transmission part, that's one, and there's the distribution side. And when you look at the challenges of India as a country, we do need to generate electricity in a much more renewable and sustainable manner.
Right.
That means less coal-fired power plants. That's what we need in India. Yes, it's a cheap form of electricity, but we need to shift away in order to have a positive environmental impact. However, in my opinion, the bigger challenge is in the distribution side. So India has a lot of power that is lost between generation and time it comes to the plugs and sockets. Whether it's through the free power we give to a lot of people who don't necessarily appreciate it. So that's a big challenge for the distribution companies to get the right returns on that investment. So privatizing it might be one avenue. Cleaning up the generation might be another avenue. And a distributed power generation like the solar panels, which provide very nice and competitive microgrid applications, especially in the villages, could be another form by which the power sector can provide more electricity to many more people without having too much of a negative impact on the environment, which is the big challenge. The complexity will come as the quality of life increases and more people come into the urban environment. And there, in the urban environment, the noise is also significant. So as we have an opportunity now with sustainable mobility like electric vehicles, the requirements on the grids, whether it's distribution or transmission, will just get even more important. They will have to do even a better job because more power will come through electricity than any other form in the next 10 to 15 years. So the good news is the demand will grow. The challenge is, do we have the business models to pay for those investments in India, especially if you're a distribution utility. Their policy changes will probably have to be made along with investments in technology.
Thank you so much, sir. It was nice talking to you.
Very good.
Please do not forget to hit the bell and subscribe to this channel. We will see you in our next segment later next week. Goodbye.